is practice.
It's 40 foot long one way and 40 foot long the other, and he said he's just taken him a long time to get used to it, and also being left hand drive, first ever competition drift car that David has been left hand driving, finds a car and all gets off the road for a long time, just about gets back into it.
Track walk and we get to see all the different cars closer. I think this car's pretty cool, don't you agree? We're 60. Good number. But now the rubber now the drifters have gone all over it, and it's and the rubber on the tyres have gone all over it.
Okay.
You can see a little bit of the inside. This might look like a real this one's an American car, because it's got a wheel on the other side. In England, we have it the other side, where I'm pointing. Look, no one's at the back. Get full back now. This guy on Instagram, there you go. Is really good. They do RC drifting as well. So far, I've seen any cooler cars than this yet. This one is another of my favourite cars at the car show today. Has gold tape on him. The engine.
These guys let me have a go inside the car. I think it's very nice of them
got a big dent in it. Well, broken. Not dented. Sorry about that. Like some of the other cars where I've been filming, it has plastic covers.
About to kick off.
I like this one.
You might have to loosen off the harness.
Look at this Mustang all alone. This tent is the merch room where I got my hat. I like the blue. I think it goes with it. Now it's time for battles. Let's have a look.
Scrappy, he's on the inside of the track. Carnage making a whole host of errors. And Bolt absolutely flies into the outside of the 7. Smokes out Scott Carnage. Carnage dives through smoke. Up onto the door.
I think he is looking for some much chatting. We'll see. See, we've
got a bit of luck there in that first battle of his in top 24 against Smokey. Ollie Bolton to take on Ignis Minilga. This one's going to be a tough one. Two guys that are going to be battling hard. Minilga didn't get on the podium yesterday, finished fourth place in the Pro-Am competition. You can see Bolton there, that Punk Motorsport S13 come through. He's going to be pushing hard, he's looking good in practice. Can he prove it? Can he get into the grade 8 up next? Well, another guy who's looking for a championship. It will be Mescalas. Mescalas to take on Silcock. Silcock would love nothing more than to take out Aramis Mescalas. Stay vegan, roll through the block on his own. He'll move through the middle of the circuit. Now this is where Bolton's going to make a big dive as he comes in very hot. Bolton absolutely fulfilling that qualifying line and onto the door he goes as he now stands on the board. Ignis Minilga across the finish line. Wow! Wow! Stefanov absolutely flying at the moment as he pins that car to that wide line, and Egan on the lock stops, almost over rotating as he pops a wheel up onto the curb, sacrificing the line again. Egan off the edge of the circuit here right now, and Stefanov looking hungry. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. David Egan and Stefan Stefanov, decisions in. Left for Egan, right for Stefanov, and there we go. Stefan Stefanov gets the win and advances through to the top 16. Judges, just scrappy by Egan there.
That's exactly it, Ian. As he chased, he had too many errors. Stefan had a really, really good lead run. And then as we come round towards clip 9, it looks like Dave's actually dropped two. So giving the win to Stefanov.
Neeson makes a huge mistake. He's panicked, he's on the ropes right now. Can Robin Neeson pull himself together and jump back up onto the side of Oliver Evans' S14 as they come round the outside zone? Evans smashes the accelerator and goes across the line.
Evans doing exactly what
Oliver
you said.
Evans out of the car, decisions inside him, left for Evans, right for Neeson. One vote for Evans, two votes for Evans. Evans gets the win, advances through. That was some serious aggression, judges, from Oliver Evans.
Yeah, what an amazing chase run, but he had the better lead run as well. There was some errors as well by Robin Neeson. He had a big mistake at 4 on a wheel off track. He cut the at 7 to 8 to try and gain, but didn't. We had advantage Oliver Evans. And then on the reverse, Oliver Evans' proximity was all over the back of Robin Neeson, and Neeson dropping a wheel at 7, so the win goes to Oliver Evans.
Gets
the winner holds it through to the Great Eight. Another guy in the championship, fighting for that championship as well. He's still in the points.
And that means we can now do the podium, the all-important bit. And I can confirm, taking third step on the podium here at round five, the MTech Breaks podium, third step, is Adam Simmons, ladies and gentlemen! So there we go, Adam Simmons takes third step on the MTech Breaks podium, and very well deserved. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Martin Wannacott! A hard-fought battle this weekend, unfortunately just couldn't hold that car together for the final runs of the weekend. And well, that just leaves two more places left to go, but before we do that, I am going to shout out the Tarmac Sports Constructors Championship this weekend. Goes to a man who's already on the podium. Give it up for your team constructors winner, Slide Motorsport, ladies and gentlemen! Slide Motorsport get the Team Constructors Championship trophy this weekend. Simmons doing double duty there on the MTech Breaks podium. And this is it. This is it. No more. Two more trophies to give out. No more other rewards. The serious bit of the business. I can confirm, ladies and gentlemen, taking first step on the podium here at round five of the 2019 British Drift Championship. Make some noise for Aramis Vaskalis, ladies and gentlemen! Aramis Vaskalis takes the first step on the MTech Breaks podium. Ollie Evans takes second step on the MTech Breaks podium. What a weekend it has been. An incredible, incredible battle. Those guys put it all on the line. And you know what? It's tight at the top right now. Wow, what a weekend. What an event.
We just got back from BDC. We got wet at the end, but we still stayed there. Oliver Evans was my favourite driver. I think his car was really cool and he was really fast. He came second place and I think he did really good. And I followed him on Instagram. And bye guys. See you on the next one.
Be sure to hit that thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe. Peace! Thank you.